First of all, it's been an interesting week. A trip down to Milton Keynes and then down to London to go and see Justin Bieber. How was it?
It was fantastic. It was a really good event for the whole team itself. We actually turned it into a team building event. We're fortunate that the club realizes that we do need to do things as a team and get away from the rink. And we ended up being back at the rink with Justin, but it was a great 24 hours, and the guys will never forget it.
Of all the team building exercises you've done, that one's got to be pretty different, huh?
Yeah, that's something that I don't think we'll ever be able to repeat. So I knew that going into it, and I wanted to make sure that we had, we had the best time, and the guys just really enjoyed it, and just soaked it all in.
Was it any different second time round? I know it was all done very, very hush-hush here, and I guess it was a similar experience, but when you get that phone call again saying you wondered whether you'll go down and go and play again.
Yeah, for me it was different for sure, because the first part was like kind of shock and this guy's really here. And the second time it was more of like a friendship. Believe it or not, he was, he remembered our names and he remembered things that we did and actually at the concert he was interacting with some of the guys, which was completely crazy. And then after he's just a normal guy and he just wants to hang out with good people. And I believe that all of our team are good people, and that's what I think sets us apart. And that's why he trusts us.
It's interesting that, isn't it? The fact that he sees you as being people that he can kind of be on a level with.
Yeah, I think it's hard to kind of to put in words, but I think what he needs is somebody that just, people that just want to be normal, and it's really hard to find that with him.
Is it hard to be like that though? I mean, it is. I know that you're old enough not to be starstruck, but he is one of the most famous people on the planet right now.
Yeah, I mean, for sure, you're always thinking in the back of your mind, like, this is pretty crazy. But the more you hang out with him, you realize that the reason why we're there is because we're normal. So it is what it is.
And what about the hockey side of it? Was it good fun? Was it a little bit more like playing back at home on the pond when you were a kid?
Yeah, we're out there just to have a good time and get him as many touches as possible. He just likes to do breakaways. And we were pretty tired, obviously, coming back from Dundee. So guys, we're out there just having a good time. It's nothing serious at all. We just want to set him up for scoring goals and keep him happy.
What about the video? The video in the van, that was something a little bit out of the ordinary. Whose idea was that?
I have no idea, because I drove the van down early with all the equipment and set it up with Dallas. So I have no idea what happened there. I saw it after the fact, but I think it was just the guys having a good time and trying to kill 3 hours, I think. Yeah. And it was good. It was a great video.
As well, isn't it?
Yeah, I don't know who thought it up, but apparently it took him 2 hours to do it, so obviously we're not that good at doing entertainment.
Okay, I'm a bit concerned about the Christmas video then.
I'm a little worried about it too. I'm a little worried about it too.
Rookie night as well. Explain what that is.
You know what? Nowadays you got to be a little bit careful about when you say rookie night, but always when it's your first year pro, you want to initiate the guys into being a pro and it's a little bit of fun. The guys, we dress the rookies up a little bit and we have a little fun with them. It's nothing crazy, but it's just...
And the worst thing for them, they have to buy you dinner, right?
Thankfully, no. That night they didn't have to, because it would have cost them a lot of money.
Yeah, London prices, it would have been crazy.
Yeah, exactly. So no chance there.
You've had a rough trot injury-wise. You've had a lot of games in a short space of time. Has this been the kind of break that you just needed as a group?
I think so. I think we've been going through a pretty tough time mentally and physically. I know the guys are banged up for sure, but we're slowly getting back into it. And I think any time that you can, you know, be out with the guys and just do any sort of thing, team building, whether it's in a van for 3 hours and doing a stupid video or whatever it is, or just having an event outside the arena, it really helps build that team camaraderie. And I think that we do have a really close-knit team. But at the same time, you know, injuries are injuries. They're going to happen. So it's just a little luck that we need on our side.